General Manager of the Eastern Caribbean Collective Organization for Music Rights, Steve Etienne, says it's left up to the discretion of the police to determine whether music levels are too loud and causing a disturbance to neighbors, especially in residential property areas. Unlike other countries, according to Mr. Etienne, St. Lucia does not have the equipment to measure music levels. Mr. Etienne's comments come in the wake of the arrest and later release by the police of Housing Minister Stanley Felix after an argument over alleged loud music at a bar the minister owns in Rodney Bay.
I think without the technology to determine the level of decibels, which is used in other territories, other countries, it's the discretion of the police. I believe any time after 2:30, according to the law, the police have used their discretion, and therefore it is down to them. Certainly after 2:30, you would believe that the music being performed anywhere should be, unless it's internal or it's an enclosed space. You have to obviously think of the neighbors, and once it's disturbing the peace as such, then the police, either through their own volition or perhaps complaints from other persons, they can in fact go in and make a determination, but it is totally at their discretion. That is, of course, without the technology, which obviously we do not possess in this country.
Ideally, according to Mr. Etienne, it would be good if the law enforcement authorities have the necessary equipment to measure audio levels, the same way they would measure speed limits, as well as equipment for forensic testing. Mr. Etienne made a special appeal to the public, be it business persons or persons who live in densely populated neighborhoods where such problems are more prevalent, to be considerate of their neighbors. The worst thing, according to Mr. Etienne, is to have a neighbor entertaining himself at the expense of others by playing loud music at an ungodly hour.
As I said, we do not have such technology in our country, so it is left to the discretion of the police. The police have discretionary powers for many things that are bordering on breaking the law. And I think it's right in a society like ours that we empower the police to use that discretion.
Now, do you think that it's time that they get the equipment to measure the music?
Of course, it would be good to have the equipment. Definitely, we are in need of equipment for lots of other matters, lots of other potential traffic violations. For example, speeding, forensic labs, testing, and so on and so forth. But it's a case of the balance of the cost of these new technological tools, implements, etc., with what the country can afford. In the absence of that, you have to rely on the police making the determination whether they deem that there is excessive noise disturbing the peace of the citizens of the country.
In the matter involving Housing Minister Stanley Felix, the minister was detained by the police for approximately 15 minutes and then told he was free to go. Police Commissioner Vernon Francois says this serves to enforce the point that no one is above the law. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.